Hello and welcome to another video. Today I'm going to make a mixed media canvas using ribbons and lace and metal embellishments and other stuff that I have laying here on my table. I've picked up some colors that I'm going to use, and I already made a simple layout, so this is my starting point. I'm going to let my design evolve during the process as usual, so I may end up using other stuff as well. I glued down pieces of a book page with craft glue. I diluted my glue a little bit with water, because it was very thick. Now I'm using the rest of the glue to glue down my laces and ribbons as well. If you're adhering fabrics or laces or ribbons to a canvas, craft glue is usually good enough. It's inexpensive and it's easy to use. But, as you're going to see later on, craft glue doesn't always work so well. As I expected, it didn't work with this burlap ribbon. So I'm going to adhere it with gel medium later on. I've also used hot glue with the same ribbon before. I'm not adhering other elements yet, as I'm going to paint my background first. I'm using turquoise paint with white gesso. I'm using small dots to mark up the areas where I'm going to use dark paint on the first layer. I'm showing the beginning of the process in real time, and then I'm speeding up. By the way, it's really enjoyable to paint on canvas with a proper brush. Most of the time I've used acrylic paints in my art journals, but I must say it's more fun to paint on canvas. Haven't done it for a while now. I'm using two shades of turquoise, turquoise blue and turquoise green, to create a little variation. If you like to check out the paints that I used or other details, I leave a link to my website in the description box. I'm using a small pre-made flat canvas. It's already primed, so I don't have to apply gesso. I'm using gesso as my white paint here. This clip is in real time again. I'm painting the edges with my fingers. Basically, what I'm doing here is, I'm creating a color gradient from turquoise to white and from white to neutral earth colors, and I'm creating subtle variations in each area. If you watch the whole process, in the end it may seem as if nothing is changing anymore, although I'm adding more and more paint. But change is happening, it's just very subtle. At this point I'm going to adhere the last piece of my torn book page. This time I'm using matte medium. It's easier to work with matte medium than it is with craft glue, but matte medium is more expensive, so I like to use craft glue if it's possible. I'm applying gesso with the same brush, and matte medium will turn gesso a little bit more transparent and soft, and that's exactly what I want at this point. Next step, I'm going to use a small harlequin stencil with modeling paste. now it's time to make some spatters with diluted gesso. Next, I'm going to adhere the rest of the ribbons. I'm using extra heavy gel medium because I'm going to add some metal embellishments later on, but I'm using it to these stubborn pieces of ribbon as well. Now it's stuck, as you can see. Now I'm adding my next color, which is pewter. First, I'm going to add it to the turquoise background with a scribble stamp, because I only want to have a tiny little bit of this color at the edges of my canvas. Before I go on, I'm adding matte medium again. Most of the time when I use old book pages in my art, they're gonna be hidden behind other layers, but this time I want them to be visible, or at least part of them will be visible. So I'm protecting them with matte medium. You could use transparent gesso as well. I'm applying pewter paint with the same brush to lower part of the old book page to make it darker. The paint is transparent, as you can see. I'm adding a drop of black to make it even darker. I'm changing to a smaller brush. I definitely want to have dark spatters as well, but not to the center of the canvas, so I'm covering it. Next step, I'm going to adhere the metal embellishments using gel medium. For this tail part, or cord, I'm using craft glue with the nozzle because I think it's the easy option, and it's good enough if you're gluing down something that is made of cotton. I want it to be curved, and it's really easy to bend using this type of glue. Now I'll have to decide what to do next. I had thought I might like to use some flowers. They're pretty and they're the right color, but somehow I feel they are not what I'm looking for right now. I'm aiming at simplicity, so no flowers this time. Meanwhile, I'm covering the tail of this embellishment with matte medium. I'm painting the metal embellishments to give them a nice vintage look. I'm using turquoise green first, and then pewter and gold. To create the same look, I decided to add turquoise to the lower part of my canvas as well. I'm going to add pewter and gold on top of it later on, but it'll peek through here and there in the final piece, as you're gonna see in the close-up photos at the end of this video. That's pewter. It's actually starting to look a little muddy, so I decided to add some gesso. Next step, I'm going to add gold paint with my fingers. Adding pewter again. White gesso. More spatters. I don't always use spatters, but this is definitely the right time to use them. It really makes a huge difference. I left the spatters dry and came back with some wooden buttons and acrylic gems. This is a pickup tool and it's helping a lot when you're handling tiny gems like these. I'm using craft glue for the first three gems, but I'm switching to gel medium later on. Unfortunately, my memory card was full, so you're not going to see me adhering the pretty little rainbow colored gems to the canvas. But I used small brush and the pickup tool, just like I'm doing right now. I used gel medium to adhere these wooden buttons as well. I decided to switch one button to a cogwheel, just for fun. I think it's looking cool in a row of buttons. Next step, I added the rainbow colored gems, but as I told before, my memory card was full, so here you can see the end result. I think they're really pretty, in a subtle way. I like them a lot. Adding the title with craft glue. I'm painting buttons with gold paint using my fingers. It's fun and it's easy. And look how pretty they are now. I'm using a stamp to add some paint spatters exactly where I want them to be. We're done. I just love it. It's so simple and pretty. I think the large embellishment looks like a hot air balloon that's flying loose over a town line. And I think it's pretty uplifting. Just fly, it says, fly free. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button if you like this video, and subscribe to see more videos like this if you haven't already. As always, I'd be happy to read your comments as well. So that's it. Have a nice day and see you in my next video. Bye!